In this video, I'm going to discuss about area, perimeter and volume of rectangle, triangle, circle, parallelogram, trapezium, cuboid and cylinder. So the first shape is rectangle. So talking about its area, the rectangle is a shape where you have got opposite sides equal in length. Now this is length, then this must be length. This is L, then this must be represented by L. This is width of rectangle, then this is also width of rectangle. As you know, area is obtained when you multiply two sides. So length multiplied by width will give you area of rectangle. Whereas perimeter is concerned, so perimeter is basically adding all the boundary length, mean length plus length, two times length plus width, two times width will give you perimeter of a rectangle. Next shape is triangle. Now a triangle has got a base and a height. Now this is a right triangle. So area will be half base into height. Whereas perimeter will be obtained if you will add the length of all these three sides, that will be the perimeter of a triangle. Now in case of a circle, area of circle is pi r square, where pi is 3.142, whereas r is the radius of a circle. Now radius of a circle may vary from circle to circle. So if you know the radius, you can find the area of a circle by using the formula pi r square. Then what about the circumference of a circle? So this boundary is basically circumference of a circle. The circumference can be obtained by using the formula 2 pi r, where pi is again a constant 3.142, whereas r is the radius of the circle. Then we have got a parallelogram, a shape in which opposite sides are parallel. In this case, you have got two sides with double arrows and two sides with single arrows. Now the sides with double arrows are parallel and the sides with single arrows, they are parallel to each other. Now area of parallelogram is base into height. Now formula is simple, but you must identify where is the height and where is the base. So this perpendicular distance between these two parallel sides is height of this parallelogram, whereas any one of these sides between which this perpendicular distance is present may be taken as base. So in this case, this is the base and this dotted line, the perpendicular distance between these two parallel sides is the height of parallelogram. Next shape is trapezium, and trapezium is a shape where two sides are parallel while the other two are not. Now here you have got A and B are as parallel sides, whereas these two sides are not parallel. Now the area of trapezium will be h by 2 bracket A plus B. Now A plus B basically means sum of parallel sides. A and B are two parallel sides, and A plus B means sum of the two parallel sides into h by 2, this height. Now here in this case, the height will again be the same, the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides. If these two sides are parallel, yes they are, then this distance is the perpendicular distance between these parallel sides. So this one will be the height. Next one is cuboid, a 3D shape where you have got a different length, width and height. Now the volume of cuboid is length multiplied by width multiplied by height. So you will get the volume. Whereas the surface area of cuboid can be obtained if you add the area of all the six faces. Now in a cuboid you have got six faces, one and one at the back, same shape will be at the back. So 1 plus 1, 2, 3 and 1 over this side, then that becomes 4, 5 the top one and 6 the bottom one. You can calculate the area of all of them, add them, you will get the surface area of cuboid. The next shape is cylinder. Cylinder is a shape where you have got a base as a circle as well as the top is a circle. Now if you want to find the volume of a cylinder, that is very simple. Multiply base area, which is a circle, and as you know, area of a circle is pi r square. So area of this circle, which is base, is pi r square, multiply by height of cylinder, which is h. So we'll find the volume of cylinder as pi r square h. As far as surface area of cylinder is concerned, that means complete area of cylinder exposed to the atmosphere. Now that includes these two bases. Now this is a circular base having area pi r square. This is a circular shape having an area of pi r square. So pi r square plus pi r square give you 2 pi r square. But what about the sides? Now that is 2 pi r. What was 2 pi r? That was circumference. Now in this case 2 pi r is this thing, this boundary into h, and you will get this complete curved surface area. So in total surface area of cylinder will be 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. So this was the basic formulas to find perimeter, area and volume of some 2D and 3D shapes. Thank you so much.